Hey, greetings. This is Brad from the Cheese Shop again. We're going to go through in this video, we're going to talk about injuries and GURPS. So if you've watched any of the other videos, you've probably already created a character. If you haven't watched them, if you've already created a character, we went through the character concept, everything you needed to do to actually make a character, and then we talked a little bit about what you do after the GM gives you a few points at the end of the adventure. I also did a video with another one of my players in another game about how to run combat, and we did go over some basics of running through just a sample combat, but one of the things that we didn't cover necessarily in that video were injuries, and that is something I'm going to cover here. I'm not actually going to talk about the amount of damage that is actually caused by specific weapons or, you know, what type of armor people are wearing. I'm just going to be talking about in this video the amount of damage that gets through the armor and physically affects your character. Now that could be, in, like I said, within combat, or it can actually be within a non-combat setting, like you fell down, or you got pushed off a one-story building or something like that, and you fell, and you took damage from the fall. So just be aware that this particular video is just going to go over injuries. Now, injuries are broken up into five different categories, and the first category that I'm going to talk about is the first level of this, and it's if you've suffered less than one third of your hit points left, your dodge and your move are cut in half. So what that means is, you know, so you have, you know, whatever, so your health is, your hit points are 10 and you've lost a third of those hit points, then your move and dodge are at half at this point. The second level, this is whenever it starts to get a little bit more damaging, is if you're at zero or less of your hit points, you need to make a health roll at the beginning of your next turn at minus one per point below zero. So again, let's say your health is 10, your hit points are 10, I'm sorry, not your health, but your hit points are 10 and five, you're at minus five of your hit points at this point, which means you've taken 15 points of damage total. You need to roll at your health minus five. Now, if you fail this roll, that means you're now unconscious. If you succeed on this roll, you stay conscious throughout that round. So the only other exception to this is if you decide to do nothing, either attacking or defending, you don't have to make that roll. So let's say, like I said, you're at minus five to your hit points, then you need to roll at your health minus five. And let's say you do make that roll, bonus, you're still awake and you're still ready to go, raring. You're still at half move and dodge, but at least you're still conscious and maybe a viable part of the actual combat still. The next thing that, the next level is if you're minus one times your hit points. So now what that means is, let's say again, your hit points are 10 and now you're at minus 10. So you're minus one, you need to make an immediate health roll or you die. So regardless of what turn is going on or who's doing what, if you get hit by a weapon and it takes you down to the minus 10, you need to make that immediate health roll. If you fail that roll by one or two, you're just dying. You're not dead, but you are dying and you've acquired a mortal wound. And I'll talk a little bit about mortal wounds a little bit later. Any injury, if you take any more injury, or every half hour, you need to make your health roll. So if that orc that was slashing on you got you down to minus 10 and you made your health roll and you're not dying yet, you're just kind of there, you're still not dead yet, and he decides, hey, not a threat anymore, and leaves you alone, you don't need to make another health roll unless he whacks at you some more. So you need to make sure, or a half hour goes by. And in combat GURPS, as you're quickly finding out, a half hour in combat GURPS is nigh impossible, pretty much. Very difficult to get through. This is seriously a deadly thing here. So once we get past this particular section, you also make these rolls at minus two times your health, minus three, and minus four times your health. So once again, at your 10 hit points, you need, not your health, I'm sorry, at your hit points, at minus 10, you make the roll, minus 20, you make the roll, minus 30, and then minus 40. If you fail that roll at the minus 20, 30, or 40 time, you don't get that little cushion of the failing it by one or two, you immediately die. You're dead. You don't get that. So the nice thing is, if you do roll well, if you roll well, you get a critical success, you're actually able to be no longer mortally wounded, which is obviously a bonus. The next level after this is if you're at minus 5 times your hit points. So you're at minus 50 now if you have 10 hit points. That means you've taken 60 points of damage, you know, that's gotten through the armor. There is no easy way to say you're just dead. That's all there is to it. Now, you say, well, why would I want to keep track of hit points after that? Well, this is the fifth level. If you get up to minus 10 times your hit points, your body's destroyed. But let's say that orc slashed at you, and let's say you failed your roll, and now you're dead. Well, you know, with orcs, there's probably you're playing in a fantasy setting, or if you're playing in a high-tech level setting, you have the ability to actually come back from the dead. So that is a possibility. That's why you would want to keep track of the extra points. But if you get to minus 10 times your hit points, so now we're talking at minus 100. I mean, so your body's just nothing. I mean, it's you cannot come back from that. So just be aware that it actually, you may want to keep track of your actual points just in case something like that actually happens. Now, those are just the five levels of the injury. So just make sure, like I said, this is all just the math. Just keep track of all the hit points that you go, and just realize that each level progressively gets worse, as it should be. I mean, this is realistic. The next thing I want to talk about is shock. So when you take an injury, that it's going to reduce your dexterity and IQ up to minus 4 for your next turn only. Now what that means is that let's say that orc hits you on the side and you take 2 points of damage. Well, for the next turn, you've got a certain amount of shock there to that, and now you're rolling at minus 2 for just your next turn only. So just be aware that that's just for your next turn. That's not for the entire combat. That's just for your next turn. Of course, if you get hit again, then you know we go back to that again. So the only thing that's not affected by that are defenses, which is a bonus. So there is some sort of a reward, just as it would be in real life. If you're in a real fight and you get hit and you get smacked around a little bit and you realize, hey, look, I'm reeling from this, you can actually take off and go the other way or try to do something else or do some sort of all-out defense, you know, prepare yourself. So that's so your defenses aren't affected by that whenever you're in shock. The next thing we're going to talk about is a major wound. Now what that means is that it's actually a single wound that you get that's half of your hit points. So again, if your health is 10, your hit points are 10, you need to make a health roll to avoid being stunned or knocked down. So if that orc hits you on the side with a club and does 5 points of damage to your 10 hit points that you had originally, then that's a single wound. So let's say he hits you with 3 and another guy hits you with, you know, from the other side and slashes you with 3, that's not the same thing. It's got to be a single wound, so remember that. And you make your health roll to avoid stunning or knockdown. If you fail it, you obviously get stunned and knocked down. And just use common sense on this. So, like I said, if he hits you on your side, he's going to knock you off to the side or, you know, something like that. So remember that where you're standing can be, you know, the utmost importance in something like this. Could knock you off something or could knock you back into someone else, you know, the spellcaster that's casting a spell and you knock his concentration off. Just be aware that there's, you need to be aware of your surroundings as well. So now let's say that we go down to knockdown and stunning. Let's say it does actually knock you down. Essentially, this is any injury that causes shock. You need to make your health roll. And if you fail, then you're knocked down and stunned. Now, with this, there are some advantages and disadvantages, and I'll let you go through the book and decide which one it is. But there's some advantages and disadvantages that affect that roll. So just be aware that of what advantages and disadvantages your character does have. Now, the effect of a stun is essentially you're doing nothing on your next turn. And at the end of the turn, you roll against your health to recover. So let's say it goes all the way around, combat comes back to you, you do nothing. GM says roll, you roll. If you fail to roll, you go all the way through combat again, you do nothing, you roll again. So you roll until you succeed. That's essentially it. So, and this is assuming that you're not getting smacked and tore up with more damage. Of course, that would affect if you go back up to the top where you have the five levels there. So if you're, so if that orc hits you on your side and knocks you down and throws you up against the rock and you're continuing, you know, you're just kind of stunned. You're not taking any more damage. You're just going to keep rolling against health to recover. Now, something separate with this of the injuries are there three types of crippling injuries, and this is basically based on hit locations. Your limb, your extremity, and your eyes, or eye, depending on what kind of campaign you're running. So, and limbs, I guess, and extremities. So with your limb, if you have greater than your hit points divided by two, that's a crippling injury. And what I mean by that is let's say that health and hit points, bear with me with that because that has something that's been a little different. So with hit points, let's say you have 10 hit points and you take 5 to your right arm. I mean, the orc decided to hit you with the club on your right arm and you take 5 damage to that limb. That is a crippling injury. But it's, yeah, I said 5. So what I mean by, so it's got to be greater than 5. Sorry, but excuse me. So if you took 6, because 5, half of 10 is 5, if you choose 6, then you actually, is a crippling injury, 6 or more. Now, let's say that he hits you with 8 on your arm. You cannot take more damage than what cripples the arm. So in that case, you would only take that the max amount of damage that it took to actually cripple the arm. So just be aware of that as well. So if he did do 8 or 9 points of damage to your arm, he really didn't do 9 points of damage or 8 points of damage to your arm, he just did the 6, because that was enough to cripple the arm. The same applies to extremities, and the extremities is your hit points divided by 3, so a third. So as you can see, as we start getting to more of the, you know, your arm is obviously a big, you know, that's a limb. The extremities would be your fingers, so they could take less damage. You know, those kind of things. So be aware that the more damage you take to those particular items, those particular pieces of your body, parts of your body, it takes less to damage those. So you still have a crippling injury on that extremity, and of course the last one is the eye, and the eyes are your hit points divided by 10. So if you have 10, it's got to be greater. So if you have 10 hit points and somebody smacks you in the eye for a point, see, not yet, but 2 points, your actual eye is damaged. So you're crippling. And this, the total damage, like I said, can never be more than the minimum to cripple the body part you're talking about. And the only exception to this is the eyes. So if they do hit you with 3 points to the eyes, they're crippled and you took 3 points. Whereas, like I said, with the extremities or the limbs, it's only the maximum that it took to cripple. Now, the effects, in the book it goes over a lot of different effects. I mean, it's like almost a half a page or 3/4 of a page. Really, for the video, just use common sense. Obviously, if you get smacked on your arm, and your right arm is crippled, I mean, you kind of know, you can kind of describe what that's going to be. I mean, and you know that if you had something in that arm, like your sword, or you were right-handed and you got hit in your right hand, you have to now use your left hand if you want to use the sword. And it drops to the ground. So just be aware that, you know, there's a lot of common sense that's involved with that. But the effects you can get and narrate out fine as the GM or even the player for that matter. The last thing about the crippling injuries that you need to know are the duration of the crippling injuries. The duration is based on your health roll, and if you make your health roll the duration of that particular injury is temporary. And what that means is that once your hit points are completely restored, the injury is gone. If you fail your actual role, it's a lasting crippling injury. And how long it lasts depends on the different roles you make, but also the tech level you're playing in and the type of healer that you have. Obviously, if I have an orc hit me on the side of the arm and I've just got, you know, we don't have anybody that has any kind of healing spells, and the thief is patching up my arm, it's probably going to be a crippled for a while. Whereas if, you know, I was in a car accident and I crippled my right arm, and with tech level 10 and the surgeon takes care of it, yeah, I'm going to be fine. But just remember that the failure, if you fail, it never is less than a month. So regardless of tech level or the healing skills, it's always going to be at least a month. So, but the time just depends on, like I said, the tech level or the healer itself. A critical failure means it's permanent. And what I mean by that is, just like it sounds, you need to start thumbing through the disadvantages in the book, in the character's book, and you need to find the limb that you lost, the eye that you lost, the finger that you lost, or some sort of disadvantage that's going to cause that to show up. Now, as you can see, we have went through pretty much everything except for the last and final thing, which obviously it's the reason why this is the last part of it, and it's death. So this is possibly where it ends, and that's, and I say possibly because there's a big maybe. Like I said before, you could be in a high tech level setting or a magic setting where you get resurrected because of the good job you did, or, you know, the amount of money that you have. So just be aware that death is not always permanent. So always keep track of your continuous hit point loss, just in case your resurrection or reanimation is possible. There is something that you can't get around, and that's instant death. If you're unconscious, let's say that orc knocked me off this side of the rock and I failed my roll and only took, you know, just a few points of damage, and now I'm sitting there and I'm lying unconscious, and you know, a mage comes over and with his little puny little knife and slits my throat, I'm dead. You don't need to roll for that. I'm unconscious. I can't defend against that. So if there's no one else around to actually help me, that's it. You know, you don't need to roll. You don't need to roll for that. I mean, that's just, it's you know, meant to be realistic. So if that's the case, you're gonna actually die. So just be aware that keeping track of hit points is always important whenever you're going through the different types of injuries, because it all depends on exactly where you're at between your spry self right now to near death or complete death, or, you know, like I said, the minus 10 times your hit points. When I say your body is destroyed, I mean your body could be completely destroyed. It could be just obliterated, you know, exploding fireball that, you know, just blows you and reduces you to cinder, you know, an ember. You know, you're not resurrected from that. So just kind of pay attention to the amount of hit points that you take. And like I said, once you get through this, you do it like 10 or 15 times. Like I said, just, you, this will be a piece of cake. You won't have to go through back the, you won't have to go back through the book. You can just write down a few of these things from the book, like put them on a 3x5 card or something, so you just have access to them, so you know where you stand as a player, and you'll be able to go through combat and know exactly what you need to roll each time. That way you're not always asking, oh, am I stunned, or, you know, am I unconscious, you know, what am I allowed to do? You know, if you write all this stuff down, then you'll know right away exactly what you need to do. And that'll make your combat go a lot more seamlessly. So I know it's this is kind of something that when people talk about GURPS, they talk about its realism, but they also talk about the fact that it is deadly. And based on this video, you'll definitely be able to see why it's considered to be deadly. You actually have the ability to, you could have a 450 point character that's a mage, awesome, been around forever, and some little nut teenager with a crossbow bolt could kill you, and he's like 60 point character. So just be aware that those things are surely possible in GURPS, And this video highlights the definite injuries that you can take and what you as a character can sustain. So if you take anything from this, just take that you need to keep track of your points, and you need to just know exactly what you need to roll to either stay conscious or unconscious, and you know where you're at in the process of combat, and that'll help. Like I said, just it'll help you go through combat much more smoothly. And I do recommend that if you haven't played GURPS before or GM'd it, one of the things you may want to do is get your players together, or even you and another person, or even if you're by yourself, make a couple characters. I mean, you ain't got to get all advantage, disadvantage, crazy. Just make a few characters or a couple characters and just roll against and just fight each other. You know, don't worry about maps or any of that kind of stuff. Just assume that they're in range and just beat each other up and see what happens. Beat each other up with no weapons. Beat each other up with, you know, find out what weapons work and what weapons, you know, really work. And you'll be able to find out, you know, like I said, how deadly this system can be, even with, you know, a blackjack or a sap or, you know, something really small. So just kind of keep all those things in mind. So as always, if you have any questions, you can always post down here at the bottom of this video or go to my website, thecheeseshop.org. I'm always posting there. So as with all the other videos, I'm going to post a link to the GURPS campaigns book. So this is where I actually got all the information. It's not in the characters book. So if you have just characters, your combat and injuries are not actually in that book. It's in the campaigns book. And I'll post links to everything down at the bottom. And I hope everybody has a good one. Thank you.